Now, at the beginning of this program, we heard from a national expert on childhood obesity who said there's no magic pill to solve this problem. It's just too complex, requires intervention at lots of different levels in our schools, in our neighborhoods, and in our homes. New interventions are being developed and tested in a local research study by Case Western Reserve University and Rainbow Babies and Children's Hospital at University Hospitals. The study is called IMPACT, and it's part of a massive nationwide effort designed to find the best ways to treat and prevent childhood obesity. 11-year-old Jake and his family are part of the study. Essentially, they filled their lives with little experiments, things they think will help fight the fat.
Pick it up. Come on.
All right, breathe. You want to go one more time?
My name is Jake Streeter. I'm 11 years old, and my dad is like my athletic trainer because when I get tired while running around, he gives me that motivation.
When you're going to push out, you make sure you breathe out, okay? Breathing is important.
For Jake and his dad, these workouts are part of a mini experiment they're doing for the IMPACT study.
So tell me about this experiment.
My experiment is sleep and exercise.
IMPACT is testing different ways to help children and families battle obesity. Jake's in a group testing an approach that calls for kids and their parents to come up with ways to make small changes in their daily habits.
One of the things that we do, for instance, to how to get a family started on this, is we have them flowchart their daily routines. Okay, what do you do first, second? The kids do it and the parents do it. And then it kind of pops out at them some of the things they do that aren't very healthy or opportunities that they could fit something in that would be healthier.
All right, so can we start with you, Ms. Jasmine? You want to tell us what experiment you've been working on?
So they go through very small, we call them self-designed experiments to change something in their environment that would be more healthy for them. We let them do experiments around diet, around exercise, which includes reducing sedentary activity, screen time on TVs or devices that the kids use today. Also, sleep is a very important behavior that we have them work on. And then stress management.
Well, I learned new words, sedentary, like has something to do with like moving and, well, not moving, like just sitting there doing nothing. So what I'm trying to not be sedentary, but like cutting my TV time out. Well, today we went for a jog this morning.
Okay, write it down.
Jake chose to focus on exercise and sleep.
The sleep part was a bit of a shock to me because I was thinking that he was getting regular sleep.
So we know that children who get less than 5.5 hours of sleep a night are more likely to not manage weight well and actually be overweight or obese.
One issue with sleep has to do with the blue light emitted from television screens. It acts as a stimulant, disrupting good sleep. Jake's experiment calls for him to make sure the TV is off before he goes to bed. Family dog Damon is part of another one of Jake's experiments.
Some of the habits we have are like when we wake up in the morning, like walk the dog, come in and just go straight to watching TV. But really we're trying to change that to like walking the dog for long distances. It's fun because they know the dog's enjoying it too. You know, if the dog's enjoying it, you can enjoy it too because you know your dog's having fun.
So was this a little tip that you thought of?
Yeah, I thought of this, like walk the dog farther distances, then you can get exercise too.
The fact Jake thought of this himself may be the magic behind this new approach to fighting obesity.
It comes from them. It's their energy. It comes from their family. They own it.
Give me like two more handfuls.
While Jake and his family are having some success with their experiments, they admit change is hard, so is battling weight.
It's a struggle for Jake. It's a struggle for myself. But each day, you know, we take it one day at a time and try and do a new thing.
The most difficult part as a parent is because you want to protect them and you're kind of like, well, I don't want kids to pick on him because of his weight or things like that. But then I've always taught my children to be independent and to like yourself because you like you, not based on whether or not other people like you. So you don't kind of want to pressure them to change because you want them to be accepted. You want them to do it because it's something that they feel that they want to do.
Besides focusing on things at home, part of the IMPACT study has a school component. Some research participants, including Jake, are taking part in the YMCA's We Run the City program. It trains teams of Cleveland students to run all or part of the Cleveland Marathon.
I'm proud of him for having the courage to push himself to do it. Being one of the bigger kids in his school, it takes courage, you know, just to keep going no matter what.
Step up. Step down on the beat.
Jake and his family are focusing on many experiments, but Impact is a massive study that includes hundreds of local kids who are trying different approaches to weight loss. After 3 years, researchers will figure out which approach helps the most children lose the most weight. In the meantime, it seems at least some of Jake's experiments are paying off. At the 2013 Cleveland Marathon, Jake ran a 1.2-mile stretch of the race.
Some of my friends were encouraging me and stuff, so it was actually kind of fun.
I'm so glad we made it to the finish line. I'm so proud of him. I mean, he's encouraged the whole family to get up and run every day.
With him, anything he puts his mind to, he can do. So I always bring him back to that. Anything you say you're going to do, you can do. So if you want to lose the weight, you can do it.
I'm very determined because I have a lot of things that I want to do with life.
Something else researchers in the Impact study are looking at are things in the neighborhood that act as sabotagers to healthy behaviors. One example is children who live in so-called food deserts, where there are lots of fast food restaurants and corner stores filled with junk food, but with limited access to fresh fruits and vegetables. Joining us more to talk now about the various environmental factors influencing the childhood obesity situation is Dr. Ron Adams, the Senior Physician for Quality at Kaiser Permanente. Thank you so much for being with us today.
Thank you.
Good to see you here. We talk about kids essentially being prisoners here. They don't have a choice. They don't get to choose where they're going to live. They don't choose where they're going to go to school. Environment, though, is so important for children.
Exactly. I mean, children, during the course of the day, go from home to school through their communities. And each one of those locuses or influence types of choices that they can make in terms of healthy eating and also promoting physical activity.
It's interesting in terms of fighting obesity, when we talk about these food deserts, the opportunity to become obese is right there. Do they have the opportunities to do something different?
Well, you have to really think about the choices that you're going to make. And when you're in an environment where there aren't many choices, there are actually some choices that you may have to search a little harder to make a better choice.
Environment doesn't just refer to home, though. We talk about the neighborhood, but we also talk about church, we talk about school, we talk about any clubs you may join into. It all ties in?
Exactly. And dealing with obesity really is a community effort. It's really something that requires a public health initiative. And so it involves not only the home, the school, your churches, all have to have a strategy to act on to make it happen for a child and a family to be successful.
Well, you mentioned the family. How can parents help to change that environment?
Well, one simple way is for a family to do what I call a food inventory. Open the pantry, find out what's there, pull it out, and look at what types of foods that you're eating. And really pay a lot of attention to focusing on labels. Because you may not realize that you're consuming foods that are calorie dense and nutrient poor. And so doing that food inventory gives a family an opportunity to see what they're really eating. Secondly is families can begin to focus on movement, getting away from televisions and computers, but focusing on activities together where a child and a family can begin to spend more time on activity. And particularly children need about 60 minutes of activity per day.
And like Jake did, walk the dog if you have to.
Find what works best for you. I mean, what we're finding is that people need to come up with their own solutions. And if you allow them to make those solutions, come up with those solutions, they will make the ones that work best for them.
You talked about the idea of pulling the food out, looking at the labels. We have to be examples, though. If you and I tell our 5-year-olds and our 10-year-olds, you have to eat well, and then we're sitting there with a bag of chips.
Well, you have to model. And if you don't model well, children will model what you do. And if you're doing the wrong things, you're not going to be successful. So obesity for children really is a family issue. You just cannot just focus on the child. You must begin to focus on the family in order to be successful.
Is it difficult for families to change all these environmental factors?
Well, it is hard. But you know, convenience is part of modernity. And so we have to kind of figure out things that we can do that While we may think they're convenient, they're actually harmful to us. And so changing lifestyle is really important. Not dieting. Dieting is the wrong word. It's really about changing a lifestyle, because the things that you need to incorporate to be successful is not something that you do for 1 week, 2 weeks, or 90 days. It's something that you're going to be doing for the rest of your life.
When you're talking to your patients, is it hard to stress the idea that environment matters?
Well, what happens is a lot of this activity is very passive. People aren't aware that these things are going on around them. They're not aware that they're not participating in physical activity. They're not aware about healthy eating. And so it seems almost next to impossible. But by giving them an opportunity to see and to also allow them to solve these problems themselves, they can come up with reasonable solutions.
Dr. Ron Adams is with Kaiser Permanente. Thank you so much for your time today.
Thank you.